I'm Mario, and this is Thursday on Geeks of the Week. Geeks of the Week. Steph, I was checking your Facebook and Twitter, and your Space Philanthropy costume came out insanely great. Never forget that while others cosplay, you cos-own. You own that ish! And I can't wait to hear about all the fun you had at the movie. Pyro, I thought you would eventually do a video in your car. I just beat you to it. By the way, you need to have your windows down when you're doing the vlog. I mean, you wouldn't leave a child or a pet inside when the window's up. So same rules apply to you, little lady. You did ask us what fictional school we would go to. Because I'm crazy, I would go to Sunnydale High. For starters, all high school feels like hell, so you might as well have an official helmet underneath it. And I feel the yearbook will have the best things written inside. Lulico, you look so sleepy and tired that we should have a nap week on Geeks of the Week. And you should totally wear your Rorschach shirt for your comic book class. And then at some point stand up and say, I'm not locked in here with you. You're locked in here with me. And Nikki, I really enjoyed your review of City of Bones. I'm sorry it wasn't everything you wanted it to be because I know you were looking forward to that movie. I'm going to try to see it before I read the books because if not like you, I think I'll be disappointed. The internet exploded on Friday when it was announced that Ben Affleck is playing Batman. Because I will approach this topic fairly, it's time for Geekable Opponent! Did you hear? Ben Affleck's playing Batman! You are taking that better than I thought you would. You're wearing that shirt on purpose, you sick son of a... I did not. I just liked the shirt. What are they thinking? What are they thinking? Okay, let's approach this rationally. He's an Oscar winner. He's a good actor and director. This might not be so bad. This is never going to work. But why? Because all I will see, all the audience will see, is Ben Affleck in the Batman suit. Maybe he can win the Soul War. But there's no way the character's going to be focused enough. Batman won't be focused in the movie he's co-starring. You do know how dumb that sounds, right? Not as much as it should be, no. This isn't Christian Bale coming in as Batman. This is a new Batman, a new origin. And let's get something straight. Man of Steel was a 2-hour movie, and they couldn't develop another character other than Superman. And they did a poor job at that. Plus, Ben Affleck is known, and that's an added obstacle. Isn't that what people said about Chris Evans? And he killed it as Captain America. Some people doubted Heath Ledger as Joker, Robert Downey Jr. as Iron Man. If we go way back, some people questioned Michael Keaton as Batman. And look how well they all turned out. That is more the exception than the rule, and you know that. For everyone that you listed that ended up good, I can give you someone that ended up badly. Nick Cage as Ghost Rider, Halle Berry as Catwoman, Ryan Reynolds as Green Lantern, George Clooney as Batman. But what does that prove? That just because you're a talented actor doesn't mean you're right for a particular role. Is there anything good about Ben Affleck you want to say? Well, he was the bomb in Phantoms. You guys realize I don't have a watch, right? But it's still that time for comic reviews from me, the best comic review in the world. Yes! I'm going to kick things off with Journey to Mystery, issue 655. Written by Catherine Nimonin and I've the letter Skitty. And this is a series finale as the mighty Lady Sif is trying to cure the All-Mother Gaia because she's gone berserk. And Betty Ray Bill's there to help. But like All-Man, his solution is to hit things hard with his hammer and just gets in the way. I already had my angry rant over Marvel canceling this title, so instead I'm here to praise it. Journey to Mystery was one of the best comics Marvel had. Great writing, it's one of the best artwork you'll find anywhere. It was my favorite major superhero comic with a female lead, and I can't tell you how rare those have become. I definitely recommend getting Nimonin's trade on this title, and I rate this final issue 4.5 out of 5. Next, Batman and Superman issue 3, written by Greg Pak and art by Jay Lee. And Superman and Batman from the regular New 52 meet an alternate world Superman and Batman from Earth 2, as Trickster God Kao is messing with them. And all this still sounds better than Ben Affleck as Batman. I mean, really? Seriously? Come on! This series has been dead on arrival. Nothing special about it. There's so many directions you could take the Superman and Batman relationship, from great friends to serious foes, but none of that is here. The plot is uninspired. The artwork doesn't give you a sense of the surroundings, so it really takes you out of the story. No reason to pick up this comic, and I rate it 2 out of 5. Next, Joe Hill's film Predator 3, written by Jason Sierra Miller and over by Vic Mahora. And former first private Madeline Greenan is trying to adjust to her life after being dishonorably discharged. But she can't because someone from her past is stalking her. He's leaving bloody thumbprints everywhere. Which doesn't necessarily mean a bad thing, it could mean thumbs up. This was the conclusion, and I was always impressed by how vivid Mally's experience was portrayed. I will admit, the ending could have had an actual message to it. There were no good guys or bad guys. No one to root for in this story. Just a bunch of messed up things that happened. And I rated 4 out of 5. Finally, Ultimate Spider-Man issue 26, written by Brian Michael Bendis and art by Dave Marquez. And Miles Morales is back to being Spider-Man after quitting for a year. He's investigating why Cloak and Dagger are attacking the Roxxon Company. I am definitely concerned for this title. It's already been rumored that the Ultimate Universe is going to go away, which would mean no more Miles Morales, and that can't happen. To me, Morales can become one of those breakthrough crucial characters. This has been a fun story. Miles' tale is always easy to follow. Marquez once again fills in for Pacelli and artwork and does an excellent job. I rate this issue 4 out of 5. That's it for me. Remember to subscribe to us. Like us on Facebook. Go on. I dare you. Follow me on Twitter. Check out the other geeks and stay geeky.